Page building in Webflow allows team members with the marketer role, whether they're a marketing teammate, client, or a less technical team member, to quickly create landing pages, all while staying within the designer's guidelines. They do this using components and static page templates with page slots in build mode. And multiple users can work simultaneously in build mode. So your event marketer, growth marketer, and product marketer can each create and build pages at the same time. This lets marketing teams build and ship new pages with speed and confidence while giving designers peace of mind, knowing their teammates can create their own pages without breaking the site or deviating from the design. So in this video, we'll show you how to set up page building so you can set your marketers up for success. First, we'll start as a designer and cover some best practices when setting up your components. Next, we'll create a static page template and set it up for marketers. And finally, we'll switch over into build mode and show how a marketer would build using the components and page templates. Let's get started with our components. These will be the main building blocks for our marketers. So before handing things off, we want to make sure our components are configured properly for marketers to easily identify and use. A best practice is to set up each component as a distinct section of your site, such as a hero section, nav bar, footer, or a CTA section with a form. That way, when a marketer starts building, all they need to do is choose the blocks they want to make up their page. Another note is to make sure to create and connect properties to elements that you want the marketer to edit. This is super important because then they can independently edit the content using the component properties you've made. And just to make things neater, organizing and grouping your properties can make them easier to identify for your marketer. And finally, make sure to clearly name each component, so the purpose of each component is clear to anyone and makes sense for your team. You can even organize your components in groups and give each component a description to provide some more context. And these are just a few things to keep in mind, but the main idea is to set your marketer up for success so that they can quickly and easily build landing pages on their own. Just remember that marketers can only add components and edit content while in build mode. Now that we've covered our components, let's move on to setting up a static page template. This could be for common page formats your team will want to create, such as an event landing page, a product or feature page, or even a paid campaign. And as the designer, you can set this up however you want. So over in the Pages panel, let's create a new page, but more specifically, a static page template. This template will act as the starting point for marketers when they create a new page. We can give it a name and description. Ideally, we want to write something that will provide context for what this template should be used for. And once we're done, we can click Create. Now we can start setting up our page template. For starters, let's say we want to make sure this page will always have a nav bar and a footer. So from our components panel, let's grab the navigation component and drag it onto the canvas. And let's do the same thing with our footer component, but at the bottom because, well, footer. And because this page template is specifically for events, let's add the events hero section so this will always be included. Next, we need to indicate where a marketer can place components. And we can do that with page slots. Page slots act like div blocks, and they indicate to marketers where they can put components. Let's drag in a page slot, and we want to make sure it's between the hero section and the footer, because that's where we want the page's main content to be. And because page slots act like div blocks, we don't need any styling to this, because it'll be sized by the content inside. Additionally, to speed things up, we could add components inside the page slot so the marketer can choose to keep or delete them from their page. But for now, let's leave it empty and let them choose what to use. Now, we can even add multiple page slots to a template, but marketers can also add as many components to a page slot as they need. But for this example, we don't want anyone to add site content underneath the footer, so we don't need to add another page slot for this template. So we're done with the static page template. Finally, let's show how a marketer would build. So let's switch gears to a marketer role. Hang on. There we go. Now, I'm an event marketer and I've been assigned the marketer role. And my goal is to create a new event page for this company's upcoming webinar. And because I have the marketer role, I'm in build mode. This means I can't move or style anything like you can in design mode. I can edit any static content just like I can do in edit mode, but I can also build pages, and that's what I'm going to do. So over here in the Pages panel, I'll start by creating a new page. And this is important. In order to move forward, I need to select a template. In the dropdown here, I'll select the Events Page template. I'll give it a name and then click Create. Now I've created a new page from this template, and right off the bat, I can see the page slot selected on the canvas. This is where I can add components. So let's do that. First, I'll add a speaker section and we'll edit its content later. Then I'll add a CTA section. And all I'm doing here is just clicking and dragging components I need onto the page. I can even use the navigator here for extra precision. And notice how I cannot add components underneath the footer or above the Events Hero component. That's because I can only add components into the page slot. This way, I'm staying within the guidelines set by the designer. Lastly, I can edit any editable static content, even if it's not in a page slot. And I can also change the component properties to better align with this specific event. And just like that, I've completed building out this whole page using the components and static page template that the designer set up. So now everything is consistent with the rest of the site and its branding. I can send this page for my team to review, or if I have permission to publish, I can even publish this site for the world to see my new page. Real quick, there are a few things to keep in mind as a designer to set your marketers up for success. The moment new pages are created from static page templates, those pages are detached and are completely different pages. This means that changes to a static page template do not affect pages that were created from that template. So as a designer, if you make any content or structural changes to a static page template, be sure to review and update all pages previously made from that template before you publish. Lastly, in design mode, if you're editing a component and you remove a property on a component, even if a marketer has changed the content on that property along with all changes to that property throughout the site will be removed. So keep that in mind as you're editing components and consider communicating with your team ahead of time. And that's it. Let's quickly recap how to use page building. As a designer, you want to create a clear and organized component library since they serve as the building blocks for your marketers to use when building pages. Next, you can create and set up static page templates with page slots for marketers to safely build in. And finally, in build mode, a marketer can take those components and page templates to create new pages on their own. And that's page building in Webflow.